Thank you for welcoming me. I'm very honored to speak today. And I hope that you take the time and the mic space to hear about just me sharing my experiences and what I learned in the past. So feel free later on to discuss with me, to object, and to disagree. But I hope that you do listen because I am very passionate about sharing this particular topic to everyone. So you might be wondering why this talk is entitled That Thing Called Tagumpay. Well, aside from really liking this movie and having a lot of hugot moments from this movie, it's really because this talk is all about defining success. That thing called Tagumpay. Why defining success? I think defining success is so important because nowadays, everyone is just so busy trying to be successful, but without knowing what really is success. Everybody else is doing a good job at work, everybody's trying so hard to study, but the question I think is, do we really know what we're chasing for? And this is especially true for our generation. The generation of millennials, we're Gen Y. We're the ones who had our formative years during the 21st century. And why do I think this is especially important to us? I think so because we have very unique characteristics, very unique, very different from the ones or the generations before us. And these unique characteristics that we have formed have translated and have developed in us different fears, very new fears that this decreased our ability to define what success is and therefore decreased our ability to achieve it well. So let me share with you what I think these characteristics are. So the first one is that we are the Insta generation. What do I mean by Insta generation? This is the social media generation. We are the Instagram generation where everyone is posting about everything that we do and everywhere that we go. So what's the result? The result is that we tend to compare ourselves with others a lot. That's because what people share on social media is really what we want other people to see about ourselves. So the tendency is we post things that are really nice about us, really successful. And so for instance, when we see someone, when we open Instagram and we see someone posting about her and her boyfriend, and single tayo. Ano yung masasabi mo doon? Kayo na. Eh, wow. Same thing with travel. Everyone's traveling now, climbing mountains, and, you know, going to Japan. Eh, dito na, ikaw na nag-Japan, ikaw na nasa under the cherry blossoms. Hindi habang ako nagpapawis ako dito sa Pilipinas. So what is the result? The result is that we are feeling envy, misery, and bitterness more than ever. And the resulting fear coming from this is what I call FOMO. FOMO. The fear of missing out. FOMO is the fear of missing out because of the so many things and so many pictures that we see online, so many posts, we fear that we are always, always missing out on something that may otherwise make us more happy than we are. But, yun ba talaga yung gusto natin? Kung ano ba yung gusto ng isang tao? Kung ano yung ginagawa niya ngayon? Yun ba talaga yung gusto natin? Kailangan ba tayo mag-ediwaw? Next. Hugo generation. That's the number two characteristic of our generation. What do we mean by hugo generation? It means that we are the passion generation. Kung gano'n tayo maraming hugot sa pag-ibig, gano'n karaming hugot tayo tungkol sa tagumpay. Lagi tayong pinagsasabihan na we should follow our passion and we should follow our passion as early as possible. Our idols are Mark Zuckerberg and Steve Jobs who have found their passion early on and have been so successful worldwide. So, what is the effect on us? The effect on us is that we feel that we are not enough. We feel that we need to become special and we need to find our passion now. The problem is, not everyone is lucky enough to find their own passions at such an early age. And so we develop this other fear. Tinamaan ang pangalan ng fear na to is FOSO. Ano naman yung FOSO? The fear of staying ordinary. that at this point, I'm already in college, but I don't know what to do. I'm still figuring myself out. And yet, these people, these great people that my mom told me to be like, it's already great, it's already successful. So that's the fear of staying ordinary. Okay, the next one is buffet generation. This is the third and last unique characteristic of our generation. So hindi lang to na mahilig tayo magsambo hojin o mag-Vikings or mag-spiral. This means that we are the generation that just has too many options. Masyadong maraming pagpipilian. Technology has given us so much innovation throughout the recent years that there's just so many opportunities around and so many ways to get them that what we become is we become paralyzed. We find it hard to pick the right option. We find it hard and so sometimes we don't even decide. Or when we do decide, we're not sure if that was the right decision to make. And so we're always dissatisfied. We're always feeling that we didn't decide well. So what is this fear? This is FOBO, or the fear of better options. That there's always a better option. Even though I picked this and I committed myself to it, at the back of my mind, I'm always thinking, ah, baka dapat yun na lang yung pinili ko. Ah, baka dapat I stayed safe. Or dapat I risked it more. So that is the fear of better options. So these three main characteristics, the Insta generation, the Google generation, and the buffet generation, have led us to have these fears that are new to our generation and that we must overcome in order to define success and therefore reach success. So, the next part of this presentation is asking the central question. So, Billie, what do you think is success? What is success? Is it money? Maybe. Because in school, this is apparently what we are designed to do. We're designed to have good grades and to land a good job and to get as much salary as we can. Is it fame? Also, perhaps, because all we want, what everybody wants, is love and attention. So maybe it's fame. Maybe. It might also be power. So President Obama is one of the most inspirational and one of the most successful people in the world. So it might be that ability to influence the decisions and to influence other people and communities. So among all these, what do I think is success? What is success? None of these, because I firmly believe that you define your own success. Success is a very, very deeply personal choice that only you can define. Your version of success will be different from how your mother, how your sister, how your brother, how your friends define success. And therefore, there's no point at all in comparing your success and your progression in that success to other people's achievements. And there is no point in being so miserable about it. So just to illustrate the idea, let's talk about how different successful people have defined their own success. So this is Thomas Edison. He is a well-known inventor. And how he defines success is 1% inspiration and 99% perspiration. So for him, success is working hard and churning out all those new inventions that can change the world. And he did it because that was his focus. So many experiments failed, but since he's still following what success means to him, he is considered successful. The next one is Tony Maloto. So Tony Maloto is the founder of Dawat Kalina, one of the most awarded NGOs here in the Philippines. And to him, and I've worked with him in Dawat Kalina, success is uplifting the Filipino. It is bringing the poor out of poverty, bringing out the genius in the poor, and therefore showing the world what the Filipino can do. So that's Tony Maloto. This is Ate Yegay. So she is actually a national artist or an artist among the Tiboli tribe. So I met her in one of my trips to Lake Cebu. And she dances around the world and of course in front of tourists just to promote and to show people what her tribe is all about. So for her, success is preserving her tribe's culture and making it known to the world. Next are these really, really good kids from Tarlac, in Ficho, Hawaiian Tarlac, who I've spent about a week in my college life. And to them, it's very different because they have a different set of values, a different set of experiences, and a different set of beliefs. What success is to them is very simple. Success to them is just being able to go to school. Being able to go to school so that they can create a better future for their community. So I'd also like to share my own experience and my own definition of success and how I believe that defining success helped me throughout my journey. To me, success is creating a positive impact among a large group of people through creative thinking. So you will see that I've used this definition of success to guide my choices in life.